These past 2 weeks, I was having this cry of bringing you back to God. So that we understand that gospel is not material.
It's
not money. Because all this we will leave them behind. Can you tell about all these things you see? You will leave them behind. So I've been having this cry, say, God, the Bible says we must seek your kingdom. All shall
fall.
So not seeking all. We won't find those all. But seeking the kingdom. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that's why I want to preach this to you today. In Luke 16.
Luke chapter 16.
Let's read from 19. Now there was a certain rich man, and he was clothed in purple and fine linen, faring sumptuously every day. And a certain beggar named Lazarus was laid at his gate, full of sores, and desiring to be fed with the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. Yeah. Even the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died, and that he was carried away by the angels into Abraham's bosom. And the rich man also died and was buried. 23. And in Hades, he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. And he cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me, and send Lazarus, that he may dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I'm in anguish and in this flame. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receiveth thy good things, and Lazarus in like manner evil things. But now here he is comforted, and thou art in anguish. And he said, and besides all this, between us and you, there's a great gulf fixed, that they that will pass from hence to you may not be able, and that none may cross over from thence to us. Can you see that? And he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house, for I have five brethren, that he may testify unto them, lest they also come into this place of torment. Can you see the verse where I'm reading? Amen. Okay. But Abraham saith, they have Moses and the prophets. Let them hear them. And he said, Nay, Father Abraham, but if one go to them from the dead, they will repent. And he said unto him, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded if one rise from the dead. Amen. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I was reading this. I was very concerned. And always I'll be saying, what we need to know is, where are we going to spend our eternity?
Before
every action we take, we need to check Where are we going to spend our eternity? I began to find that one of our best problems when we are living on earth, we are failing to see far. Because can you see where we have read here? If you can check in this Bible, let me show you where I was reading. Where the Bible says, when this man was in haze, when he looked far, he was able to see far when he was in haze. But the question was, why was he failing to see far when he was in the world? There was riches around him that kept him busy. His focus was his presence. You see, when I was reading this, I realized that one of our best challenges, it's a distant. It's just a distance. When there's a distance between us, our eyes began to fade. We began to fail to find out what is happening on the other side. I even thought about what if we are able to see another planet. What is happening on the other side? This can really change our character. I don't know if you're hearing that. Okay, look at this verse. Let me read it again. Because when I read it, I was just challenged by this verse. Alright, look at this verse. It says, especially verse 22, 23. And it came to pass that the beggar died, and that he was carried away by the angels. Think about here, the Bible never show a space of this man alive separated with this man when he's dead. He died and carried away. In other words, the moment when he failed to breathe, the angel took him away. But this rich man, after he died, he just died, boom. The Bible says he was buried. In other words, everybody was saying the burial of this man was powerful. He was buried. It talks about the burial of him, which is what we are focusing on. That we are focusing on the issue of the grave, not after grave. And the Bible says he found himself in haze now. In other words, he fall there. The moment when he look up like this, he see a man he used to see at his gate. Can you see, able to see another planet? You are seeing what is happening in heaven. How are you going to live? If now this man might have seen that there is a hell and there is a place where you are supposed to be comforted, this man, what he will do, he will just try to say, this thing that I'm having is useless. This ends by the grave. But there's a life to come. Look what this man is saying. He says, can I say this, Abraham? In my family, we are all like that. We are full of pride. Our focus is the grave.
rivita.
And there will be tombstone. And there will be meat everywhere. No cold drink, juice.
Everywhere.
And Abraham said, yeah.
Abraham,
you know what? Your brothers, there are people that are appointed by God.
There is
the law, which is the Bible. And the preachers who are the prophets. Minor and major prophets are there preaching. If this man can't hear them, if this all your brothers can hear them, they will come to your place. When this man was in hell, he can remember his brothers. He can't forget Lazarus. Lazarus was still the same person. And he can even know Abraham, who we have never seen before. He had too much knowledge. He had enough knowledge that he never had when he was on earth. He had enough sight that he can see beyond and see far. Tell your neighbor, say, my friend, one of your problems, you can't see far. You see around you. And this has affected you. If you want to see why Christians today
they
have problems, they can't see there, they see. Even their prayers is of
here.
If you have got a challenge now,
you
go for fasting because of that
challenge.
But a person who can see
far
is a person that cannot be changed by anything. He cannot pray for anything because he knows what is coming. I don't know if you're hearing me.
Pastor
said, your problem, you can't see far. You can't see at the distance. Let me show you a scripture that will also help us. In Matthew 10, Verse 34 to 39. You find
Jesus
speaking about what will affect people so that they won't see what is coming. He says what? 'Think not that I came to send peace on the earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. For I came to set a man at variance against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law.
Amen.
And a man's foes shall be they of his own household. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. He that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that does not take his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it.
Yeah,
and he that loses his life for my sake shall find it.
Jesus
knew that people can't see far, and they are affected by people around them. And he said, if now you need to know, maybe you will understand why the kingdom of God is like this. I have not come here to bring peace. Don't expect blessing. The moment you say, I've accepted Jesus, the people of the family you love will fight you so that you lose where you are going. If you can't see far, you will cry. You will question, why these people are doing this to me? Here, Jesus, I have brought a battle. A son, a daughter, if you love them more, you are not worthy of me. You know, what Jesus was saying, you have been given people around you, but don't love them and you forget that there's a distance where you're going. There's a place where God wants you to be.
Because
the same people, devil can use them to make you know to reach where you're supposed to reach. I don't know if you hear me. If you love your wife more than me, it's possible that you can sin because of
you.
If you love your daughter or your son more than me, it's possible that you won't do what the Bible says. And also you will go there where you were supposed to be seen. Our characters are determined by our destiny. If you know where you are going, nothing here can hinder you. You'll make sure that you change everybody around you. And everybody will know who are you. One of our challenges today is there are things which are better than God around us. And those things blindfold. And we forget that there will be the end of the time. This man, and Jesus also spoke about that. That there's nothing that can buy your soul. I don't know if you're hearing that. So because the soul is the one that will stand at the last. And all these things won't be there. Look what is happening in the church today. We are affected by people around us. If your parents say this is not a church, you leave the church. Even when you know the truth. If your parents say let's worship an idol, you forget that there's a time where your parents won't be there. This brother left his brothers. And it's on the other side tormented. Thinking about his brothers. And Abraham said, hey, everybody here for himself. God for us all. Everything here is for yourself. You determine your destiny. You know, I was looking at it, I said, hey. If truly we know that there's heaven, I won't allow Eunice to disturb me. Because I'm seeing a place. The day I fail to breathe, she will be breathing. The day she failed to breathe, I'll be breathing. So I must determine myself. I must be more determined by where I'm going. Tell the
neighbor, hey, be determined in your Christian life to where you are going.
There's only one man that when I read about him, I'm encouraged.
It's
Job. When the wife say, insult your God and die. Job say, you are foolish. You speak like a foolish. We must accept when God does this.
Even when he blesses us,
because Job knew. He said, Job knew. He knew that even his body was like that. He will see his Redeemer when he dies. Our Christianity today is receive the car.
Amen.
And the same car is the one that will bring death and we find ourselves in hell. Our Christianity is focusing on things today. It's not focusing on him. We are focusing on how big we can be. What is it that we can have? We can't see far. We can't see beyond. I want you to see that there will be rapture one day. I want you to see that there's
Jesus
and you will meet him one day. I want you to see that there will be the end time and the real life will be visible. When now people are saying they are burying you, where are you going to spend your eternity? See far. Don't be disturbed by people around you. Whoever is around you, is there to provoke your action if you are still in faith or in sin. Whoever is around you challenges you, whether you are still the same
or
person
who knows where you are going.
If you see where you are going, you won't allow anybody to disturb you. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
You know, I've read the scripture here in Luke 17, especially verse 27,
verse 27.
Luke 17, where the Bible says, talk about the wife of Lord. And Jesus said, remember the wife of Lord. The wife of Lord could not see there.
Mosadi aloto pale she ka bona kwale.
What she was seeing, where she come from.
She
could not see there.
Na
she was given a promise. Run there. With the husband, run there. You'll be safe. But she never did that. What she did, she looked back. And something wrong happened. If you read Luke 9, verse 52.
Let's read 62.
He says, no one puts his hand to the plow and look back is fit for my kingdom.
That's what
Jesus was saying. What makes us to look back? Challenges. Troubles.
Whatever
we are going through. If now we carry back, we move back.
We
look back. We are not fit for the kingdom. I don't know if you're hearing that. Ask somebody say, are you able to see far? Are you sure you are able to see far? If you know you are able to see far now, even some of your prayers, you won't pray there. You won't pray. You will know why these things are happening to you. Can you see you've got a problem, you've got sickness. And you are praying,
go.
But if you are able to see that you're going to be healed, you'll begin to change. And to say, thank you, Lord, for healing. If you are able to see far, your prayers will be more of thanking Him than crying to Him. I don't know if you're hearing me. Are you able to see far? What will happen this year? What will happen in the end? If you know what will happen in the end, you won't worry about your enemy. You won't worry about what devil is doing. Because you can see far. You can see the end. Nothing can distract you from your Christian life. So you won't look back. I don't know if you understand. You won't look back. You will carry on until to the end. I want to carry on until to the end. Sin makes you to look back. Challenges makes you to look back. Problems makes you to look back. Where you are, don't look back. God has moved you from the things of the past. Don't go back to the things of the past. Remember the wife of Lord. When Jesus said that, He was saying it's a lesson to all of us. I don't know if you're hearing me. That is why if you look back, you look forward, you look back, look forward. It is possible that you can lose focus. From there you lose your destiny. Looking there and there affects your destiny. Let me prophesy someone who's listening to me. God is opening your eyes right now to see far. You'll be able to know what will happen. You'll be able to understand what will come. You will be able to live your Christian life. Can I tell you this? I see some people here. Even their prayer life will change because of their seeing something there. They see themselves with Jesus. I don't know if you're hearing that. A Christian who sees far can't see. Can't see. Because he knows, if I sin here, what about
there?
Do you know why you sin? You can't sin far. I mean, you are just looking around. Your attention has been taken here. You are seduced here. And your attention has been taken to go to a wrong direction.
And end up sinning there.
If you want to see Christians why they are sinning, they are blind. They are short-sighted. But those who know there will be hell, those who know that there will be heaven, if they want to say something, they say, no, I can't say it. They want to be angry, no, I can't be angry now. They know how to fight, but they won't fight. I don't know if you hear me. They know how to do something, but they won't do it. They will deny because their eyes are seeing their destiny. They are seeing Jesus calling them. Let me give an example of one man. Before he died, this man, I mean, I was close to him with mama. So he was killed by the dust. He used to do this thing of tombstone. So that dust entered him.
A dust yela ya motsena.
So now, 2 to 3 weeks before he died, even when we go there, he will be telling his wife and say, hey, are you seeing these people? Can you see these people? They are calling me home. They are calling me home. Before he even died, he sees angels calling him. But you can see far. You just see demons appear. And from there you say, hey! And they say, we are here to take you. No one can help you. You can see if you are surprised. Many accidents, many problems that are happening to us is because we are short-sighted. I'm praying today that you see there. And your character will change. Your obedience will change. I don't know if you are hearing me. Can you ask your neighbor, how far are you seeing? Because people can't see, they are blind, they complain. Everything makes them to complain. They complain about everything. Whatever they see gives them concern. Let me show you this, Hebrews 11. Verse 13 to 15. The Bible says they all died, controlled and sustained by their faith.
Amen.
They confess that they are strangers and temporary residents.
Amen.
If they saw, in other words, they saw the place where they are going. They confess that they are strangers and they have got a temporary visit and there is home. And that home is heaven. Look at this verse also in Hebrews 11:35. Let's read there. In Hebrews 11. Verse 35. Can you read that? Verse 35.
Hebrews 11.
Read Amplified Bible.
Balanga AMP.
Hebrews 11.
Hebrews 11.
Verse 35.
Read
Amplified.
Balanga AMP. It says
what, Mama?
Oh Jesus. Woman received back their dead by resurrection, and others were tortured to death.
Yes.
Refusing to accept release offered on the condition of denying their faith so that they will be resurrected to a better life.
Can you hear these people of faith? These people of faith, the Bible says, out of the faith, this woman, they have seen their children resurrected. But now also they were offered an opportunity to deny their salvation.
They
might be offer money, blessing, whatever. And when now they scorch them, when they troubled them, because they were denying, they were looking unto the real thing they were looking for. They deny everything here because of what they are going to encounter there. The real deliverance to them was there. I don't know if you're hearing that. Can you read that verse again, Mama? Read that verse again. Verse 35 is important for 35. Christian life.
It makes,
in other words, I mean, when the moment you reach that level, there are things you deny. You deny. You can rather suffer because you know what will happen in the future. Read verse 35 in Amplified Bible.
Women received back their dead by resurrection, and others were tortured to death.
Others were tortured to death.
Refusing to accept release offered on the condition of denying their faith.
There was a release they were given. Offer in the condition
so that they will
of denying their salvation
so think that they will be resurrected to a better life.
They say, okay, it's better you kill us, beat us, whatever you can do. But when we get this pain, when we resurrect, we resurrect in a better way. Think about it. They deny anything that affect their salvation because they know that where they are going to be comforted. Where they are going, they know there's a journey in front of them. Can you read verse 36, Mama?
36.
And
others experience the trial of mocking and scourging amid torture and even chains and imprisonment. They were stoned to death. They were sown in two.
They were sown in two.
They were lured with tempting offers to renounce their faith.
They were lured in tempting offers.
They were put to death.
I love that. Mama, imalap.
Okay.
They were lured in tempting offers.
By labor fiwa di locha uba hukela.
It was like this. When, you know, most of the time it happens. Now you are in a group here. And they were told that, you see what? Whoever wants to say he's no longer a Christian, we are giving you a house. We are giving you a car. And 5 million. Lift up your hand. Another one lift up here and say, yeah. They did that knowing that they will repent later. And it's already they have something now. It's too late. They've been rejected. But there will be these ones who say, no. I can rather, die without those things. But when it happens, when they say that, they take one. And say, you are denying. Look what we will do to you. They lift them up. Another one, they leg this side. Another one, they hold another leg. They cut them being in front of them. And say, can you see? When you deny, we do like this. We do like this. And these ones were there, they say, it's better we face this. So that when we resurrect, we resurrect in the best way. We need Christians who can see them. Not who can see here. Do you know why? You can accept any offer to find Jesus. It's because you can't see what is happening. Your world ends here in burial and you go to hell. But if you know there is God, you can rather be scorched. You can face trial. You can face opposition. But you don't care because you know where you are going to spend your eternity.
bophelo ba gao ba o ya o ile o tlo go fetsa ka go tlo ma le o
You see, our Christianity is not like of them. Many of us, we have not faced challenges. Many of us, if we are offered things, we will take them. Many of us, we are living a wrong life. Influence, as long as we are eating.
As long as we are eating.
Many of us, we can't see what will happen. Whatever comes on earth, if it is satisfying, we take it. Can I tell you this? We need Christians who say no to ungodliness because of their sin. If you see here, you can be robbed where you are. We need Christians who can see the coming of the Lord, that the house money comes. All these things we are trying for, they are useless. Can you tell car how you tell your neighbor what you are crying for is useless? Those things can buy your soul. And listen to this. I found that when you are a Christian and you are seeking only, all those things will search for you. But when you search for them, they will never come. They will never come to you. What you need to do is to seek Him every day. Because you are seeing where you are going. Money will follow you. Cars will follow you. All these things that they are crying for will come to you in the name of Jesus. I don't know if you are hearing me. We need Christians who see far. How far are you seeing?